My name is Father Mark Bernhard, the associate pastor at the University Catholic Church in Aurora. And it was ordained that by Bishop Conlon last May. So thank you, Bishop Conlon, for ordaining me a priest. There's been a story in the news the last month that has really captivated everyone around the world. This is captivating me, it's captivating my prayer. Those who are in the university know this because I've preached about it once or twice, using the image, and as I prayed with the scripture passage this weekend, the image was there again. And the story that's captivating the world, really, this past month was the story of the 12 wild boys. 12 wild boys, you may know, were the 12 boys of the soccer team in Thailand. Along with their coach, they were exploring a cave in northern Thailand when they were deep within the cave, there was flash flooding, so the waters rose quickly, and the boys, along with their coach, were trapped in a cave for weeks. There was a period of 9 days where the people were searching frantically, divers from all over the world, looking for these 12 boys and their coach. And there was a pair of British divers who found the boys. When they found the boys and the coach, they were huddled up on the edge of a cliff inside the cave. Once they were found, the rescue efforts could get underway. The rescue efforts got underway, they did, right? They had all over the world, we had Navy SEALs and engineers coming together and thinking and game planning different ways to deliver and rescue these boys. And even a billionaire by the name of Elon Musk, right, developed or formed a team, and they drew up a game plan and designed these different pods and trying to get in there to get the boys to deliver them out because there were passageways and parts of the cave that were barely enough to fit a single body, let alone a current of some spots in the cave or water. Some people think that the efforts were impossible. I think the world being fascinated so much by the story because the hearts were moved by these boys. Like, everybody was seeing a little clip of the boys huddled up with these, heat-warming blankets and flashlights in there. It was pitch black dark. The anticipation. Where are they going to get rescued? How are they going to get rescued? Well, we were all moved with pity, I think, when we saw them. Jesus in the gospel today, right after previous weekends, he sent out his disciples and they come back today and telling Jesus what they've done, what they've been taught. And then a new group of crowd comes. And when he disembarked and saw the vast crowd, the scriptures say, his heart was moved with pity for them. Why? For they were like a sheep without a shepherd. When Jesus saw them, he saw people who were alone, who were scared, who were hungry, needing someone to stop and feed them. Not just like with substantial food, but telling them how to act and how to live. Jesus saw there, his heart was moved with pity because the people were waiting. So as those boys were found, and the engineers and the Navy SEALs from all across the world, right, they got together and they're coming up with different solutions. First they thought, well, we're just going to teach the boys how to swim with these expert divers and teach them how to navigate. But they quickly thought, well, the way this is going to work because they're going to panic, they're going to get scared, they're going to drown, put themselves at risk, and divers at risk. So what they ended up doing was a Navy SEAL would take a boy and tether him to himself. And he would pull him along the cave. All while he was holding the oxygen tank. And there'd be another Navy SEAL behind him. So each boy had a pair of Navy SEALs that would lead and navigate them through the passageways of the cave. Each trip took 2.5 hours for each one of the boys. difference between a bad shepherd and a good shepherd. A bad shepherd, woe to the shepherds who mislead and scatter the flock of my pasture. You have scattered my sheep and driven them away, and who will deliver them? He says, I myself will gather the remnant of my flock and bring them back to the meadow. Brothers and sisters, we need to know with confidence and call upon the Lord to know that He is the shepherd. And Him to not, like, in the midst of, as we're sitting on the bleachers or up here, not the sanctuary, but the gym floor, right? This is to know with confidence that Jesus is the shepherd who tonight maybe wants to tether us to Him. And, like, pull us out of the cave that we might be in this moment. Because life is hard. Family life is hard. The pressures, the concerns, the anxieties. Like, we can feel that we're in pitch black darkness at times. The pitch black darkness that's only found 2.5 miles in the cave. And there's a Lord. So easy to find us. All we have to do is make the smallest of noises. Like, just the smallest of noises, He knows where we are, because right now He's navigating the tunnels of the cave, right now, searching for us, wanting to tether us to Himself and pull us out. Now, what are the bad shepherds? Maybe in us, right? Bad shepherds are in the church. Bad shepherds are voices, maybe specifically, that we hear in our culture and society. I mean, I'm thinking that looking at the crowd here, very young crowd, two bad shepherds come to my mind. One is the shepherds of, the bad shepherds of the voices, and don't hear what I'm not saying, both of these things are good things. But I've become more and more aware as the years increase of how these two good things can be really, really bad. And both of them I've had experience in my life, and I've seen how both of them have been a bad shepherd, if you will, for me. One is video games. Video games are good, but they can be bad. Who knows when I say Fortnite, raise your hand. Yeah, there's some smiles, right? Where we drop it, right? Where we drop it. I recently had a college student in my office 2 days ago. No, yesterday. Who has been completely overtaken by darkness because of video games. Not because he's playing bad games, right? But he's playing games too much. There's too much of a pull on him towards those games, right? So he's telling me, Father Mark, last night I stayed up till 4 o'clock in the morning. I didn't want to stay up till 4 o'clock in the morning, but I did. Don't get any ideas if you're not staying up till 4 o'clock playing video games right now. But that could be a false or a bad shepherd for us, is that voice of being too much of that. The other thing is sports. Here we are. Baseball camp, the beginning of a baseball camp, you need to maybe boys and girls or maybe your parents say, don't you dare follow what I'm saying, right? Anything about the sports game. Well, I think with confidence, like, I do want to go there. Because sports can be a bad thing. And I can say that with confidence because it's been the case in my life. Growing up, the false god that I had in my life was sports. You name the sport I played in. Basketball, baseball, volleyball. If I wasn't playing, I wasn't both. I was watching sports on TV. Bulls, Bears, Blackhawks, and especially the Cubs. Any Chicago team as long as one of the White Sox. But see, sports overtook my life. In a way where I remember my junior year in high school, I was in pitch black darkness, and I can attribute 90% because I was overtaken by sports. if you become a better baseball player, but you don't know, or I don't know, that Jesus wants to tether me to him and drag me out of the cave that I want to be in tonight, then we will totally miss the mark at this game. Or maybe this, because a lot of people like are here at the Catholic baseball game. We're talking, like, I'm preaching to the whole crowd here, right? More so to the whole crowd than maybe normally preaching on Sundays at one of the six masses that I live in New York City. So maybe boys and girls and parents and myself, may the prophet Jeremiah today. Jeremiah doesn't say that I will appoint one shepherd. It is true that Jesus Christ came and he is the shepherd that we want to follow. But he says, I will appoint shepherds, plural, for they will shepherd my people. This year, this gym right now, has got to become a gym of people filled that know and desire to be shepherds. Maybe to go and the people in our lives that we know are in pitch black darkness, that we know right now are huddled up on the side of a cliff inside of a cave. Why? Because they don't know Jesus. They don't know his goodness. They don't know that their life matters, that God has a plan for their life. We've got to become shepherds that go inside a deep, dark cave. Hold them up and blast them to ourselves, to carry their oxygen tank, and to guide the narrow, crazy paths of the cave, and to lead them to the light. It is said that when those boys finally exited the cave, they had to wear dark sunglasses so their eyes could adjust. The world has run amok in many ways. You know that. I know that. He is so bright. He casts such a bright light. Will we be shepherds to go in and rescue you, your friends, your neighbors, your family members?